gonna talk about something that's on my mind. So, in my relationship with the Lord, I know I look a little old right now, but in my relationship with the Lord, when I first came to Christ, I was like many of you guys, or a lot of people. I only prayed when I needed things, or when I wanted a promotion, or was studying for a test, stuff like that that we normally pray for, right? And after I gave my life to Christ, got born again, the Lord began to deal with me to say, why don't you pray for more? There's much more to the power and prayer that Jesus did than just pray for the things that he wanted. Why don't you do selfless things and pray for other people like Jesus did, right? And do these miracles, signs and wonders. And I said, well, you know, I'm not a pastor, I'm not a evangelist, I'm not a prophet, I'm just a person. So I didn't think that, I never thought that I could do something like that. So it just made me think things through. And I remember praying probably about 5 years ago, praying and saying, Lord, there's got to be more to life than just being a Christian. And I could feel the Lord tell me, there is. You need to go be like my son. I told you, go pray for people and I'll do some miracles, some healings. And I came across that night, I prayed and I said, Lord, if this is your will, speak to me and I will do it. And I came across a couple YouTube channels, people on the streets, Pete Cabrera Jr., Mike Todd, I can't remember some other people, Torben Sondergaard, praying for people in the streets and they're getting healed. And the Lord began to deal with me and said, that you can do the same thing, Carlos. And I was like, don't I have to go to school or something? Nope, just by faith, step out by faith and do it. So I remember I prayed, and the next morning we went to take my daughter to gymnastics. And I prayed for this man that was coming in this in through the doors. I went to the next door, there's a Culebra Meat Market, to her gymnastics. Prayed for this older man who had a crane hit his foot probably like 15 years ago or something. He said his foot was never the same. It was in a lot of pain. Me and my son laid hands on his foot, prayed for him, and he got healed. That was my first miracle encounter since I prayed that with God. And it was amazing. The man only spoke Spanish, so he was like telling me in Spanish, walking around the Culebra Meat Market, hopping up and down and saying, what did you just do? My foot doesn't hurt no more. And it was pretty interesting. But there's so much power in prayer that we give little importance in the body of Christ to prayer, but we should give a lot of importance to prayer. Speaking and believing are both hand in hand, the power of prayer. By faith in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you guys.